Hello and welcome to my review of Anti-Graviator. Anti-Graviator is an anti-gravity racer, of course, as the name suggests, made by Cybernetic Walrus, and it is published by Iceberg Interactive. Currently it is being sold on Steam, but in the future it will also come to PlayStation Network for PlayStation 4 and to Xbox One. So I've played this game almost 1.5 years back when it was still in the alpha state. And back then it had good controls and nice graphics, but it had a weird sound issue that on the track, if you went into a tunnel or a viaduct or something like that, the sound would cut out. So it had a weird sound issue. But for the most part, it was a really nice beta. Then in May last year, they started a Kickstarter, and that failed, unfortunately. But the game still got made, and it got picked up by Iceberg, and it released a couple of weeks back. So let's have a look at that game. So this game has 15 tracks in total. 30 if you include the reverse tracks. But it also has some mirror races. It's just not an option like in other games. It does it automatically during the campaign, at least I've seen. So you don't have control over that. But if you take those into account as well, then you can say that the game has 60 variations in total. The track design is really cool. This was the most important thing for me, because I'm always interested in races like this. But for example, with Redout, the track design just didn't click with me. It was too much straight stuff and not enough loops and curves and weird stuff like that. And in this game, that's in overabundance. So I was really happy with the track design. But the only thing that I think could improve is that at the moment, most tracks feel a little bit empty. And that's what I've seen with a lot of modern anti-gravity racers. I would have liked to seen stands at the side of the road with fans in them just watching the race. I think that would have made it a lot more livelier, and also then you feel like you're actually racing in a competitive cup or a championship like real racers on our world. So yeah, that's a complaint that I have with this game and many modern anti-gravity racers. But the tracks themselves, which are the most important part, I guess, are really nice, at least in my opinion. And the second most important thing is the controls, and as I said in the intro, they were nice in the alpha, and they, for at least to me, they feel unchanged. They are still really nice, so nothing to complain about there. Moving on to sound, the soundtrack that you can hear in the background, it is serviceable, but it's not a standout. Like, I don't have any songs in here that would get me really, really excited while racing, like the licensing tracks from a game like Wipeout. But they do the job, and they aren't getting annoying to listen to after a while. So it's okay. For the cars, there are only 3 Graviators at the moment, so that's not a lot. And the last one takes a lot of money to unlock. So for the most part, you will be racing with 2 if you are doing the campaign. And I would have just liked a little bit more variety there. But the devs have said that they are making a new car. And more about that later on in the review. But now I'm going to go a little bit more into the negative side of things. I've encountered a lot of small things. For me, one of the main things is audio stutter at the start of the race. This happens almost every race. And sometimes also in menus. I spoke with 2 developers. One guy said it was maybe my audio setup. The other guy said that it was a known issue and that they don't really know how to fix it yet. I don't think personally that it is my audio setup, because I've tried it on two different setups, two different sound cards, and also with lots of different settings with bitrate and sample rate. So I can't say for sure it's the game or my setup, but it's something to take into account. And that's also why I said there were audio issues in the alpha, in the intro. It is a different audio issue, but audio still is something that is pretty hard to fix, I guess. And other little things, sometimes the AI got stuck on a track, especially when there are loopings or really, really tight turns. But I've only seen it three times during my playtime. So it isn't something that happens a lot, but I've also seen it in the Discord that it happened to some other people. And sometimes I got stuck. There is a weapon that you can use in the game in a space race that creates huge red orbs, and they throw missiles at that. But if you activate it yourself, you get a shield and you can't get damaged. But it still stopped me, and it turned my car around, so I couldn't continue. And I don't know why, but the game doesn't have a respawn button. So I basically had to quit the race and the championship, and I needed to start over. So that was pretty annoying. I don't know why there was no respawn button. I really hope that they implement it in the future. And another thing also in the space race, and this happened a couple of times to me, was that I was disappearing in a track, and it was always the same part. So that's also something that should easily be fixable. And another thing that isn't necessarily a negative, it was just weird to me, the menus aren't exactly normal. For example, when you have finished the cup and you have become first, so the best result that you can get, it says back to menu, and if you press that, it says are you sure? And that's because it's the same button than what you use if you quit a cup before the last race. And then of course it's normal that it asks you are you sure that you want to quit, so you don't do it on accident. But if there's no other option, it's just weird that you get the extra pop-up menu. And also when you're starting a new cup after you've done another one, and you finished first, you would think that the game would show you the newest cup, the most difficult cup that you can do at the moment. But every time it starts at the first cup, the novice cup. So I don't know why it does that. I think it's a weird design decision, because I don't think it's a bug. And another thing is the graphical menu. There are some things there that are missing that I would think would show up there, but then they show up in the camera settings. So, as I said, not necessarily a negative, the settings are there. It's just, for me at least, weird placement. And I've asked around to a couple of other people, and they also thought that some of the placement of options was a little bit weird. Also, the game has no rebindable keys yet, but that's also something that the dev is planning on adding in. And another thing that I found was pretty cool was that you can rename bots you're racing against to make the game a little bit more personal. So yeah, I just think that's a nice touch. One thing that I was disappointed by was that you couldn't turn off some of the effects that you get if you are boosting or an FOV slider. If you look at video, you can see that the track distorts a little bit around the edges of the screen, especially while doing stuff like loops. Luckily, it looked a lot worse on video than it actually feels like while playing, but it's just something that I would like to change, and I think that's easily fixable with an FOV slider. Because now you have the same distortion, for example, if you play Quake Champions and then pick 130 or 155 FOV. You also get that weird distortion with a big that you get from a big FOV. And also I would like new camera settings, but again, that's something that the dev is actually adding to the game. So again, it's nice to see that the dev is actually active and changing the game. And now we come to my two biggest problems with the game. The first thing is the traps. They are very much hit or miss. Some are very nice and are doing what you expect them to do. Others are way too strong and basically can kill your race while being very hard to avoid. so it's just not implemented very well. And I think other racers do this a lot better. And I've seen a lot of people complain about this on the Steam forums as well. But the devs have announced that they are going to add in a race mode where you can race without any traps. So that should fix it if you don't like the traps as well. And my other big problem is the difficulty spike. So when you start out, it's pretty easy, but then it gets harder and harder, of course, the further you go. And then you come to the Silver Cup. And I had a configuration of my gravity racer that wasn't really made for acceleration. And it turns out that for this cup you need a lot of acceleration. So I was pretty much screwed. And I didn't have any money to basically change my upgrades. So what I needed to do was to grind a lot, go back to previous cups and get enough money to upgrade. And I mean grind a lot. I think I've played the same cup over and over and over again for maybe 20 times and I still don't have enough to be able to buy stuff to actually beat it. So that's why I haven't finished the game yet. And I've also seen a lot of other people having this complaint as well, again on the forums, all with a silver cup. So I've spoken again with one of the devs and they say they are looking for a solution and they are trying to fix it. But in the meantime, this is just a really, really big problem for the game, at least to me. Because I really liked that I wasn't seeing too many repetition in tracks and there were many different tracks. Because one problem I had with races like this is that they most of the time use something like how Wipeout does it, with only a couple of tracks and lots of repetition of those tracks in different cups. And that's always something that I didn't like about races like this. And unfortunately, that was something that Anti-Graviator was able to avoid for a long time. But then, without a warning, just because you chose the wrong upgrades, you need to grind a lot. And that's just something that isn't well thought out. But yeah, I really hope that they are going to update that and fix it. So, overall, well, I still think this is a great game. It feels very good and I've had a lot of fun with it. They just need to fix all those small little issues, but luckily nothing game breaking, except maybe the difficulty spike. But yeah, if you know that you need to have acceleration, then you can upgrade to that from the start, so that should help you. But I do really think that the game has a good base and that it can become a really, really great racing game if they sort out those small little things. The only other thing is that the multiplayer for the most part is empty only when you go to the Discord page and ask people to do a race. You can do a race online, but that's to be expected with a little indie racer. But yeah, I think it's a really impressive game, especially if you think about how many people worked on this game. And I will make an update on this review as soon as I finish the game. To let you know if something has changed about my opinion and also to give you an update on what has been added or fixed with the game. So for now I would give it around a 7.5. I really enjoyed my time, but I just can't go higher because of the little things. But yeah, thanks for watching and see you all next time. Goodbye.